This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, in the last four sessions, I discussed concentration of solution. I discussed different ways to express concentrations like percentage by mass, percentage by volume, mass by volume percentage. I discussed strength, I discussed molarity, molality, parts per million, mole fraction, normality, and I discussed direct formula based questions. But in the exam you may find questions like one concentration will be given and another concentration will be asked. I call these types of questions as convergent type questions. Conversion of one concentration term into another concentration term. One way of solving these types of problems is you memorize the relation between different concentration terms. And another method is conversion method, which I am going to talk about in this session. Many times using this conversion method, questions can be solved within 30 seconds. But for that, you need to know the basic definitions of the concentration terms. To understand this conversion method, I will take a question here. Here this question says, a solution is given whose molarity is capital M, density of the solution is d gram per ml. If the molecular masses of solute and solvent are M1 and M2, then find molality of the solution. Molality of the solution has been asked, molarity is given. One concentration is given, another concentration is asked. That is why we can say this as the convergent type of question. Because it is important to identify first whether question is of convergent type or not. Then use the method which I am going to tell you. In this method, you draw a vertical line. Left hand side, you write the known concentration. You write the known concentration. And right hand side, you write unknown concentration. Unknown concentration. For known concentration, use definition. I will tell you how to use this. And to save time, unknown concentration, for this use formula, basic formula of the concentration. For example, in this case, molarity is the known concentration. So I will use the definition for this molarity. And molality is the unknown concentration. So I will use formula for the molality. Now, recall the definition of molarity. Molarity is number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of solution. Now this definition I will read out and then write. Molarity is what? Number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of solution. So, with the help of the data, I am able to write two data. I repeat, definition of molarity is whatever I am reading out, I am writing. Molarity is number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of solution. So with the help of definition, I got two data. Now for formula of molality. Formula is what? Number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent, mass of solvent in gram in 2000. Again, you see how many data required? Two data required. In the formula, two data required. With the help of definition, we have written two data. So actually, it's a game of two data. Here required, here given. So we have to convert these two data into these two. That is why I call this method as conversion method. My point is clear. Now, look at the first data. Number of moles of solute. Here, number of moles of solute. Directly we can substitute here. The only thing is now we have to find mass of solvent. But what is given? Volume of solution. Volume of solution given. Density of solution given. Density of solution given. If density of solution given, volume of solution given, whose mass we can find? Mass of solution. That is what? Volume into density. 1000 d. Look at the unit of density, gram per ml. Here volume is given in ml. That is why mass of solution will be in gram. Now we have to find mass of solvent. Solution consists of solute plus solvent. So if you want to find mass of solvent, you have to subtract mass of solute from this mass of the solution. But mass of solute not given. What is written here? Number of moles of solute. If number of moles of solute known, is it possible to convert moles into mass? Yes, because we know mass is equal to moles into molar mass. So I can directly get mass of solute as molar mass of solute into molar mass of solute into number of moles of solute. So it will be m into m1. I will substitute here m into m1, and then mass of solute solvent will become what? 1000 d minus m m1 into 1000. So this way I got the molality in terms of molarity. My point is clear. I repeat this for you. Whenever one concentration is given, another concentration is asked, we can use conversion method. In the conversion method, left hand side of this vertical line we write known concentration, right hand side of this vertical line we write unknown concentration. To save time, for known concentration we use definition, for unknown concentration we use formula. Here molarity was known concentration and molality was unknown concentration. But please keep in mind, this method is applicable only for conversion purpose. Otherwise, do not say that number of moles of solute as capital M. Capital M is molarity. But during the process, capital M for us is number of moles of solute. But before the process and after the process, capital M is what? Molarity of the solution. Here, definition of molarity is, number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of solution. So two data we have written on the basis of definition. Now here, formula of molarity is what? Number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent in gram into 1000. Again, here two data required. So our job is to convert these two data into these two. And for that, we can use some basic formulas. My point is clear. Now, I'll take one more similar type of question to understand this conversion method in a better manner. Here the question says, a solution is given whose molarity is capital M, density of solution is d gram per ml. If the molecular masses of solute and solvent are m1 and m2 respectively, then find the concentration of solution as percentage by mass. So here percentage by mass is the unknown concentration and molarity is the known concentration. So again, it's a conversion type question. So what will you do? Vertical line, left hand side we will write molarity. For molarity I will use definition. Right hand side I will write percentage by mass. And for that I will use formula. What is the definition of molarity? Molarity is number of moles of solute present in 1000 ml volume of solution. And what is the formula of percentage by mass? Percentage by mass formula is mass of solute in gram upon mass of solution in gram into 100. So two data you have to find. You have to convert these two data into these two. Numerator mass of solute required, but what is given? Mass moles of solute. So how do we convert moles into mass? By multiplying the molar mass. So it will become mm1, number of moles into molar mass will give you mass. Now denominator mass of solution required, what is given? Volume of solution. So how do we convert volume of solution into mass of solution? By multiplying the density. So if you substitute here d into 1000 here into 100, quickly you get answer as mm1 upon 10d. My point is clear. So this way we get relation between percentage by mass and molarity of this solution. So this is actually relation. Either you memorize the relation or you use this conversion method. I'll take one more example here. Here the question says, a solution is given whose molality is m, small m. If the molecular masses of solute and solvent are m1 and m2 respectively, then find mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Mole fraction we have to find, one concentration. Molality is given. So again, this is a conversion type question. So left hand side the vertical line, what concentration will you write? Molality. And for that you have to use definition. Right hand side, what will you write? Mole fraction. And for that what will you use? Formula. My point is clear. Now definition of molality is what? Molality is number of moles of solute present in 1000 gram mass of solvent. So with the help of definition I am able to write two data. Now what is the formula of mole fraction of solute? Mole fraction of solute is actually moles of solute upon moles of solute plus moles of solvent. Now moles of solute directly given, you can substitute here upon m plus. The only thing you have to find is number of moles of solvent. Since mass of solvent given, how will you find moles of solvent? Moles of solvent will be mass of solvent upon molar mass of solvent, that is m2 here. So I will write 1000 upon m2. So this is the relation between mole fraction and molality of the solution. Dear students, in the same manner we can find relation between all concentration terms. Now here I have taken a question which has numerical values. Now see, question says a solution contains 12% by mass of sulfuric acid and density of the solution is 1.1 gram per ml. What is the molarity of solution? First part. What is the molality of the solution? Second part. Again, the percentage by mass given, molarity is asked. So it is a conversion type question. Percentage by mass given, molality is asked. It's a conversion type question. So quickly, what will you do? Vertical line, left hand side, you will write percentage by mass, because percentage by mass given, and for that you have to use definition. Right hand side, what will you write? Molarity. For that you will use formula. Percentage by mass, what is the definition? Percentage by mass is given as 12. So 12 is what? Mass of solute in grams present in 100 gram mass of solution. And what is the formula of molarity? Molarity is moles of solute upon volume of solution in ml into 1000. Now mass of solute given, but we have to find moles of solute. What will you do? Mass upon molar mass. H2SO4 is the solute, so 12 upon 98 is the molar mass of H2SO4 into volume of solution required. What is given? Mass of solution, but at the same time density of solution is given as 1.1 gram per ml. So mass upon volume means 100 upon 1.1 into 1000. My point is clear. Now if you solve this, it comes 1.346. So 1.346 is the molarity of the solution. In the exam, no need to write these things. Orally you have to do this, and that is why it will take time less than 30 seconds. Believe me, you practice this method, it will not take time more than 30 seconds. Here I am writing these things, that is why it is taking time. My point is clear. Now I will show you how does it take less than 30 second time, this method. Look at the second one. Look at the second question. Percentage by mass given and molality we have to find. So what will you do? Use the definition. 12 is the mass of solute present in 100 gram mass of the solution. And molality you have to find. Molality formula is moles of solute upon mass of solvent in gram into 1000. Moles of solute 12 upon 98, and mass of solvent will be 100 minus 12 means 88 into 1000. And by solving this, we get 1.39, and this is the molality. Now you can see, less than 30 seconds, you can solve these types of questions. These are convergent type questions. Okay, but you have to practice, and with the help of practice, you will be able to solve these convergent type of questions within 30 seconds. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.